Hi everybody, Joel Colander with Rock Island Auction Company, here with the first of many videos for our 2017 December premiere firearms auction, and we're starting off with a bang. The table's not very full, but it has a couple of true powerhouses on it. These are only going to be available to the best collections, the upper echelons of collecting, which is why we want to show off. We want to show them to you now and just give you a taste, a bit of an informal taste of what's to come in this auction. We won't go into the whole history, but just look at them. Just look at them and marvel for a minute with me. Pre and post history, a little bit of Colt manufacturing. It's all right here in a very crucial, important time for the Colt name. On the left, we have a number one. It's a baby Patterson, one of the earliest Colt firearms ever. It was not incredibly well received. There was quite a bit of improvement, as you can imagine there are with most of our first efforts. You'll notice the distinct lack of trigger guard. You'll notice the lack of trigger. The trigger, of course, pops down. When you cock the piece, there's a tiny spring trigger that folds down from the front. This is actually interesting because it's not only a number one pocket Patterson, but it's also an Ehlers number four model. That's an Ehlers, E-H-L-E-R-S. The Pattersons had room for improvement. They didn't sell as much as he liked in any of their sizes. A man named Ehlers took over the manufacturing leftover components after Samuel Colt basically had gone bankrupt on it. And so Ehlers produced some of the Pattersons. You can tell too, we'll take a look at the top barrel strap here. Here on the address, it does say still Patent Arms, which relates to Colt. It says Patterson, New Jersey, but it no longer says Colt Manufacturing, but it does say Colt's patent because Colt was no longer manufacturing these. We'll have the history all up on our website before too long. There's obviously plenty to go around on that piece. And not a lot of people are familiar with that part of the Colt story. Just like Smith & Wesson would go bankrupt two decades later before re-emerging, Colt did the same thing in the 1830s. The Pattersons, while allowing for improved firepower, still had their problems. As can be seen with the Ehlers improvements, he was able to improve upon them right away. But they still had potential for their firepower. And someone who saw that potential was Walker. Walker was a military man fighting down in Texas and Mexico at the time, and he loved the increase in firepower over some of his single-shot pistols. So he came to Colt when Colt was looking for military contracts and made a few suggestions. And up through those suggestions came the 1847 Colt Walker, the revolver that now bears his name. As you can see, there is a slight size change from the previous Colt iteration to the next, mainly because one of Walker's primary requirements was that the new revolver had to be able to kill a man or horse with a single shot. And the Walker is certainly capable. Here you can see we have quite an increased bore diameter. We have just a massive pistol, a massive cylinder for holding a very powerful charge. And to hold that powerful charge in new cartridge, the revolvers had to be necessarily bigger and heavier. Using what we would consider today a primitive metallurgy, more metal was stronger metal, and so the result is a very large and heavy revolver. Looking up close, we can see that this is a C Company Walker, number 172, well documented previously with other C Company Walkers. And it goes without saying that Colt Walkers are a holy grail for Colt collectors. 1,000 were made, an extra 100 made for the private and commercial market, and of course some presentations from Samuel Colt, as he is wont to do. With only 1,000 made, very few of them survive today. They didn't survive, first of all, the life that they led, fighting on horseback in Mexico and in Texas and in the South. These were literally ridden hard and put away wet. A common method of cleaning them at the time was to boil the cylinders. To have any survive is pretty much a miracle in and of itself. You're gonna see some pitting. You're gonna see signs of hard use. In fact, one of my favorite signs of hard use is back here on the right grip, where you have five notches, top notches on the back grip. Just a holy grail piece for Colt collectors, both very important pieces to the lineage of Samuel Colt, and we are very proud to offer them. Again, this is in our December 1st, 2nd, 3rd Premier Firearms Auction. Stay tuned for more videos and keep an eye out for the full catalog listings on www.rockislandauction.com.